Good morning, y'all. I just wanted to share with everyone this this dream that I had. I won't get into to too much of details about the dream, but I just wanted to share what the Lord had given me to tell his people. So on May 20th, the dream started off. I was in a grocery store, and while I was in this grocery store, I heard the woman on the announcement say 30 minutes till closing. 30 minutes till closing. So I'm walking around shopping, and then it came, you know, time that it was time to almost go. So everything was on the right side of the store where you check out. So it was self-checkout. So as soon as I went to go check out, something told me to like go under the machine, like to look. So as I looked under the scan machine, because I felt like I dropped something, there was like an opening to it. As soon as I stuck my head underneath, everything went black. When everything went black, that's when the Lord spoke to me. He says, the order of Melchizedek is being set in order. Time is running out. Get ready. And I was like, the order of Melchizedek. And then I popped my head out. And when I popped my head out of that little compartment area that it was in, everybody was gone. There was nobody in the store. The lights were off. Everything was like dark, like the store had already been closed. And I says, I just put my head underneath this thing to look for something, and that was it. So I ran to the store, like the front of the store, and there was a man there. And he was just like, he said the weirdest thing to me. Like after he asked me, he said, where did you come from? I was just like, I came from underneath the thing. And he looked at me and he says, that's not the first time that this has happened before. And you're not the only person who this was said to. And then after that, a couple of things happened after that. And then I ended up waking up. But the Lord says that the order of Melchizedek is being placed in order. It's being set in order. So time is running out, he said. Time to get ready. It's time to get ready. We need to get ready, people. We have to get ready. Get ready. And the only way that we can get ready is repentance. Asking the Lord to forgive us for anything that we've done. Checking ourselves daily. Checking ourselves daily. Getting into the word daily. You know, it's not just the thing anymore. We can't pretend anymore. We can't, you know, love God one day and then jump into the world the next, or the next hour, and keep filling ourselves with ungodly things. We need to stay focused on Jesus. Stay focused on him and you will prevail. You will prevail, but you have to stay focused on Jesus. There's no other way. There is no other way. It's repentance. Repentance is key. And it's staying close to him, at his feet. We need to be at his feet. And the only way that we can do that in a correct way to get into his presence is praise and worship. It's true praise and worship. And me, I love praise and worship. I love praise and worship. That's my thing. But it's getting, it's what'll get you into his presence. There's no other way to do it. So I just wanted to share with you that. There's going to be many more that I have, many more things that I have to say. Even the dream that I had today, which I need to ask the Lord for confirmation of what it was. But, you know, it was really deep. It was really deep. It had to do with the end times. And man, oh man, time is running out. Time is running out. The Lord said, time is running out. Get ready. We have to get ready. We have to get ready. We have to. We have no choice. It's either you serve the Lord, or you live in this world, which it's nothing. It's all materialistic things. All these things are gonna pass away. We need to get right with the Lord. Repentance. That's what it is. It's key. That's where you first start off. Is repentance and seeking God, getting to the Word, building that core. Building your core with the Word. Filling your core with the Word. If you don't know what your core is, it's right there in the center. It's filling it with the Word of God and everything that God has for you. You know, getting to know who Jesus is. You know, looking at everything that he did. Start off in Luke. Me, the Holy Spirit had given me Luke chapter 8. And when I started that, it was just one thing after the other of what Jesus was doing. And what that was showing me right there in the Bible was the characteristics of Jesus. And how he was and how he operated, and it showed his love and compassion for people. And it's just like, you know, that's how we need to be towards each other. So I encourage you today to get into the Word of God. And I just want to thank you. And like I said, this is just one of many videos that I need to be releasing, because I have to be obedient. Before, I was holding back. I have so much stuff. And I was so unsure of, like, Lord, do I release this now? And it's just like, hey, it's time to release these things. It's time to release these things. I can't keep holding on to this word. I can't keep holding on to this word. I really can't. It has to be released. It has to be released. Because, you know, God will keep giving you things. But the second that you stop being obedient in giving these things out and speaking what he gives you, everything, like, I was getting things and all of a sudden it stopped. It stopped because I stopped. I stopped seeking God. I stopped spending time with him. And it's just like, nah, I can't do that. There was something inside of me saying that, like, it was like, I need God. I have to spend time with him. It was bothering me because I wasn't spending time with God. It was bothering me. Like, I couldn't function. I couldn't function right, because I kept saying to myself, something's wrong. Something's wrong. Something felt wrong inside. It was just like, and that was Jesus. That was not spending time with him. That was not giving him his daily. You know what I mean? Even speaking to him, I wasn't even doing that. But I said, you know, I had to cut people off. I had to stop a lot of things. I had to stop a lot of things. But like I said, you know, this is just the first video of many that, you know, I started a couple before, but I have to do this daily, because I need to tell people this is a thing, you know, people of God, women and children of God, and that's everybody who is listening to this. You need to get ready. You have to get ready. You have to. I'm telling you, you have to. You have to. If you value your life and where you will spend eternity, you have to make a decision. It's you choose life or you choose death. And death is a life without Jesus Christ. So like I said, I encourage you, get into the word, repent, ask God to forgive you, ask him to help you. Have him, you know, let him be the center of your life. Let him be the core of everything that you do, you know. So I'm just going to close with a quick prayer. I thank you, Father God, for each and every single person that is listening to this word, Father God. I pray that you touch their hearts, Father God, that they hear you, Lord, that they hear you and that they receive this, Father God, to get ready, to let people know, Father God, let their families know. Let their families know about what you're doing, Father God, your end time harvest, Father God, this last, you know, hoorah. That's what it is, the last hoorah, Father God. I pray, Lord, that we are all ready to receive everything that you are about to do, and let your glory just fall on us, Father God. I pray all that in Jesus' name. Amen. Be blessed. And like I said, get into the word.